I turned my basement into an aquarium lounge, and this is how I did it. I started by emptying the basement out and planning out the build, kind of getting an idea for what I wanted to do with it. Then I began building the stands, and I built them the same way I always do, and I actually have a ton of videos on how to do this, so if you need to know how to build an aquarium stand, just check out my other videos. We won't have time to do it in today's video. The canopy was, of course, next. These won't only cover the tanks, but it's also going to keep my cats out, which we're gonna talk about in a minute. I built these out of 2x4s and attached them to the upright supports that are attached to the stands and then to the studs of the wall. Oh, and why the TV? Well, the entire wall from there to there is just under 17 feet. Each tank is 6, which leaves me a little less than 5 feet in between. You might be thinking, geez, Joey, it's unlike you. Why wouldn't you just chuck another fish tank in there? Well, the TV makes far more sense. It'll make this area far more practical for everybody to use. The basement is 50% of my house, and I don't want to take it completely away from everybody. So having a TV there, especially for my son who likes to play video games. Which brings up another point. I also built a 6-foot-long table to sit at, to play board games at, to watch the fights or play video games, or more importantly, for my daughter to have a place for her and her friends to play their games at, which they already were. So if I get the fish tanks, my son gets the TV, my daughter gets the big table, what's Tamara get? Well, Tamara gets a mini bar with a fridge built in it for her wine. And that's how I got away with this. More fish tanks in the house, but a little something for everybody. Anyways, back to the build. I used 1/2-inch plywood to cover all of this. I don't need this to be pretty. I just need something sturdy enough to keep my cats out of the tanks and have something to attach the styrofoam to. Mind you, all of this was actually inspired by the aquarium gallery's new walls we built. You guys will remember this. We gave the illusion of these actually being walls with tanks built into them, then covered it in wallpaper. Looks absolutely phenomenal. Now, because of my cats, I don't want a lot of doors on this, but they gotta be big enough to actually access a lot of the tank. So I used really big hinges for the doors that were 4 feet long. I then used XPS styrofoam because it's already dark and not as messy as other types. However, it's not safe for aquarium use, but that's not a problem, it's on the outside. I also tested this with my cats to see if they would claw it and scratch at it, and they tested it a little bit, but it seems as though they have zero interest in it, so it's absolutely perfect. I glued this to the plywood with construction adhesive and just waited a couple days for that to cure. Now that brick pattern you're seeing on all of it, well, that's inspired by my house. I'll show you. The front of my house is brick. As we go in the front door, more brick. Come around the corner. The fireplace is brick. Luke, you are not brick. So not only do I get to have more fish tanks in the basement, but I gotta make it practical for everybody else and make it kind of suit the style of the house that we live in. I'm doing all of this for a very specific type of fish, and I'm going to show you or tell you exactly what they are at the end of this video, so make sure you keep watching. Now, it actually turns out that my level was roughly as wide as the bricks on the front of my house. So I use that. This helped me trace the bricks, but also keep them level and straight. The bricks are about 7.5 or 8 inches long and maybe 3.5 inches tall, maybe even closer to 4. I knew that once I started burning in the lines that I would lose a bit of the brick. Then I took a hot knife and burned out the lines. This step takes a lot of ventilations and fans running, and it's going to take quite some time. Even though the styrofoam's 1.5 inches thick, I burnt into it by about 1 inch. This gives it some real depth and 3D dimension look. Now with this all traced out, I briefly ran my heat gun over it all. This darkens the styrofoam a bit and hardens it. Hardening it is great for adding paint to it and or stopping my cats from clawing it, which again, they haven't done it since I've set all this up and I built it quite some time ago. It's still going strong. Now I could have stopped here and just painted over it, but I did think that the bricks didn't look real. They were too perfect. So I took my heat gun and pushed it into the styrofoam within centimeters of it and melting it even more in places, kind of rotating the gun around, tilting it in different spots. I didn't want everything to be symmetrical, and this made it look perfect, giving it a much more natural look. Now, originally I painted a lot of the walls in this basement black and my daughter did her own thing with her door. But then I decided I'm going to paint this side of the basement black as well, because we do have white ceilings. Painted this black, and then I thought, well, why don't we just paint it all black? Because to be honest, I was going to go gray, the same color as the front of the house, and I did try it, and it looked horrible. This looks awesome. Very contemporary, classy looking. Well, maybe you don't think so, but I do. So the paint was actually just a basic black latex paint. I did one coat, I didn't need a lot, and it dried within about an hour to touch, and it worked out perfectly. But then I was stuck with, what am I gonna do for scape? Because I wanna keep a specific fish, but with two tanks side by side, I thought, wouldn't it be kinda cool to have it look like the scapes are combined, and the only thing separating them is the TV? So I took a bunch of manzanita wood that I had, kind of separated them into their own separate piles, of course, after Luke had one, had a piece for himself, and began to try to scape the tanks and mirror it. Now, I am low on this type of wood, so it was really tough to find pieces that would kind of look the same, and I wouldn't be able to mirror the tanks exactly, but I could do a basic idea of them. Now, I'm not sold on this scape yet, which is why I never continued with it. I mean, the manzanita is gonna probably float and it's all gonna get ruined anyways, but I just kind of wanted to set it up, see what it would look like, and kind of go from there. But I think the scapes actually turned out really cool. Behind the tanks, the walls are black as well, so I don't need to put a background on here. So this is tank one, and then this would be tank two. I am partial to tank one, although this does look good. Obviously, I gotta clean the tanks up, I mean, but yeah, isn't that amazing? Now look at this, if we come step back, the only thing lighting up in, well, Tamara's wine fridge, but if the only thing lighting up in here is the tanks. Isn't that amazing? Now check this out. I can just light up these lights that are in front of these tanks, and that looks pretty cool, but I can control all the lights down here, so it's kind of like whatever kind of vibe or look we're looking for, so we'll try a couple. Maybe something like that, or maybe just light up behind it, or all of them. Yeah, it just looks absolutely phenomenal. I'm obsessed with it. Now, a couple of things I don't like about it. Oh, what about the fish? Can you touch me from there? I don't want you to hit me. I want in both tanks. I do not like these massive gaps. However, I couldn't figure out a way, watch this. Watch how big my doors are, but the cats cannot open them. Oh, and I've got to put styrofoam behind this to block out the light. When I cut it, it wasn't exactly straight. And then when I did the heat gun, when you're using a heat gun, it will melt back and shrink everything. Look how big that opens. This side does not open. I don't need it to. I've already tested. I get up on my little ladder and I can touch the bottom. This door does not open. If you have Savannah cats, you'll understand. If you don't, you're gonna be like, oh, you should have put the doors and just put strong locks on it. It doesn't matter. These are little raccoons trapped in cats' bodies. So this doesn't open, but I can access it through here. I think there's just a bunch of supplies and tools in here. Just little magnet clips. No door handles. You gotta really get in here, stick your fingers in so you don't rip the styrofoam off. And both of these open. I'm going to be using canister filters and they'll just go there and there, not a big deal. This one opens over here as well. Again, just little magnets on them. That's why there's a gap. See how I had to kind of angle it? So that sucks. And I had to do it here as well. Not a huge fan of that, but man, tell me this doesn't look real. Well, you guys seen the entire process, so of course you could see that maybe it doesn't look real now, but the corners were also, I had to take some spray foam, fill this in and then trim it off because the styrofoam didn't touch completely, but that wasn't a big deal. Spray it in, let it ooze out and fill so you have more to work with and trim, and that was that. I find the rougher things are, the more natural it looks. Another thing is this is the beginning of a panel and that's the beginning of a panel. I didn't think it was gonna look like that until I started putting it all together and cutting it, and then I was like, oh no, when I heat this up, this line is not supposed to be there, for example. That's not supposed, see how it cuts this brick in half? So if that wasn't there, you wouldn't even notice. But when I heat it up, that's what I was talking about, like it will kind of separate a bit. Isn't that cool though? Tamara's got my little logo on it, Tamara's little wine fridge. But yeah, isn't that a cool little spot? Oh, and this is my heat pump. I was worried that it's gonna cause melting or something. I've been testing it. Again, this has been done and set up for weeks now. If you're a member of the channel, like the OnlyFins, you've seen all this. I think I want to spray paint these black. Anyways, the main construction of everything's done. There's just some tinkering around, some fine tuning. You know, I wanted to show you guys, see if I missed anything or something I could add or do differently. But for the most part, everything is completed. And I think it's a really, really interesting and cool space for 30 to 40 hours of hands-on work. But the more you screw up, the more natural it looks. Like, this is so cool, isn't it? Now, I was thinking about doing this to the inside of the tanks, and I think it might just be too bricky if I put it in there. But I think this is going to be a really cool tank. Low maintenance, low energy aquariums. The lights are consuming maybe 20 watts. The filter will be another 15 to 20 watts. I won't need a heater in here because of the fish that we're keeping. And it doesn't get anything below 20 degrees Celsius in here, and that's fine. But yeah, really, really cool. Lots more to add and finishing touches, but for now, this is kind of one of the things I've been working on behind the scenes, but I have a few other things that I gotta do as well, so I'm gonna get back to that. Oh, what about the fish? Can you touch me from there? I don't want you to hit me. I want in both tanks. Fancy goldfish.